Greetings. Welcome to the presentation of Peter and Andrew's recirculating aquaculture system. Recirculating aquaculture systems, RAS, represent a new and unique way to farm fish. Instead of the traditional method of growing fish outdoors in open ponds and raceways, this system rears fish at high densities, in indoor tanks with a controlled environment. Recirculating systems filter and clean the water for recycling back through fish culture tanks. New water is added to the tanks only to make up for splash out and evaporation and for that used to flush out waste materials. Fish grown in RAS must be supplied with all the conditions necessary to remain healthy and grow. They need a continuous supply of clean water at a temperature and dissolved oxygen content that is optimum for growth. A biofilter is necessary to purify the water and remove or detoxify harmful waste products and uneaten feed. The fish must be fed a nutritionally complete feed on a daily basis to encourage fast growth and high survival. Let us first see this flow diagram. Culture tanks. Fish can be grown in tanks of nearly every shape and size. Circular or oval tanks with central drains are somewhat easier to clean and circulate water through than rectangular ones. The size of the tank depends on a variety of factors including stocking rates, species selected, water supply, water quality, and economic considerations. The tank must be designed to correspond with the capacity of other components of the system, particularly size of the biofilter and sump, so that all parts of the system are synchronized. Sump. Through culture tanks, the water with the use of gravity flows to the sump. A sump is used to prevent the excessive accumulation of fish excretory products and waste feed. Waste products increase the biological oxygen demand, decrease the dissolved oxygen content, lower the carrying capacity that can be reared, and may result in off flavor in fish products. Pump. The pump is used to lift wastewater from the sump to drum filter. Drum filter. The drum filter is a mechanical self-cleaning filter designed for systems where it is essential to prevent particles from fragmenting. The modular design makes it easy to maintain and adapt the filter to your flow capacity and performance requirements. It provides an easy way to handle solids, preventing fragmentation and delivering high filtration efficiency. The Peter and Andrews RAS drum filter has a modular design to give high flexibility and is available with a choice of drum and tank materials for use in different environments. Slurry sits in a tank with a partially submerged drum. As the drum rotates into slurry, vacuum pulses the liquid through the industrial filter media, trapping the solid particles on its surface, forming a cake. As the drum continues to travel through slurry, the cake thickens. As the drum emerges from the slurry tank, spray bars wash the cake, allowing air, water, and the remaining liquor to travel through the drum section into piping, through the valve, and into a vacuum receiver. As the rotary vacuum drum filter begins to rotate facing the ceiling, it enters the drying zone. The drum remains under vacuum, pulling air through the cake for more dewatering. The drum then reaches its discharge zone as it rolls to the position just over the slurry tank. Drum filters discharge in a variety of ways: scraper discharge, belt discharge, string discharge, roll discharge, and pre-core discharge. Water retention tanks. Water retention tank is used to store water coming from drum filter. What makes them retention tanks is that the water is retained to be used for one purpose or another, rather than simple allows to drain. Three-stage biofilter. The three-stage biofilter is used for detoxifying ammonia and nitrogen. We utilize different media types to achieve each stage of filtration. first stage mechanical media often includes coarse sponges, filter floss / wool, the ceramic white cylinders aka ceramic noodles. Second stage biological media, beneficial bacteria will grow on any surface in the tank, and generally speaking, the more porous the media, the easier it is for a bacteria colony to grow and replicate. Some media types used today are bio balls, bio wheels, ceramic noodles. Biomax from Fluval is a highly porous cylinder. Substrate Pro from Ehimar small, highly porous balls. Third stage chemical, the most common chemical media is carbon. It has a short life, usually around 4 weeks, and absorbs impurities from the water such as tannins, leached from driftwood, medicines and odors. Also available are products that absorb phosphate, nitrates, copper, and there is also a product called a water softening pillow that can be used to reduce general hardness, GH. Aeration chamber. Successful fish production depends on good oxygen management. The addition of oxygen as atmospheric air is called aeration and is essential to number 1, the survival, respiration, of fish held in high densities, number 2, the survival of aerobic, nitrifying bacteria on the biofilter, and number 3, for the decomposition, oxidation, of organic waste products. Aeration is done with the help of aerators in aeration chambers in the water that comes from biofilters. UV sterilization. The aerated water from aeration chamber is sterilized using UV sterilization. UV radiation is responsible for sunburn, of course, and it is the same type of damage that UV inflicts during sunburn that kills microorganisms. UV sterilizers direct the water flow close to a UV bulb. The effectiveness of the unit depends on the intensity of the bulb, the average distance of the water from the bulb, and the flow rate. The clean water after sterilization flows back to culture tanks with the help of gravity, and this cycle continuously goes on. This was the Peter and Andrew Zare's design explanation. We hope you liked it. Please check our website www.peterandandrewzares.com. Thank you.